How to use VLOOKUP function. In this video, we will use VLOOKUP function to bring the number of cards produced by these countries from this data set. Let's see how this is done. So the way the VLOOKUP formula works is that you type is equal to VLOOKUP brackets open what, meaning what you are looking for, comma where, meaning the data source or the data table where your data is, comma the number of the column in the data set, and whether you want an approximate match or an exact match, indicated by true or false. Let's apply this formula here. We need to look up the number of cars produced by these countries in this data set. As you can see in this data set, we have about 41 rows where we have a lot of countries, and we can see the number of cars produced by these countries and the number of commercial vehicles produced by these countries, but we are only interested in these six countries. So first, just to look at the number of cars produced, we'll apply is equal to VLOOKUP brackets open. What do we want to look at? It's this country. So just click on this cell, comma. Now I go to my data set and I select the table and I select the entire range so that I do not miss any country. At this point, what I should do is freeze my cell range. So as you can see, this is data sheet, and from cell B3 to F44, this is the range of my data. What I'm going to do is press the F4 key and changes into this dollar sign. These dollar signs are added next to the rows and columns, and this will freeze the range so that when I move the formula or I copy the formula, the range does not change. Second thing, I need the number of column. So as you can see in this data, my first column is the name of the country, and the second column is the number of cars produced. So I will put 2 for second column, and then I put a comma, and then I type false because I want an exact match, and false here represents an exact match. Now brackets close, and as you press enter, you see your number. Now if I drag this formula down, as you can see, Excel automatically picks up the number of cars produced by each country, and as you can see, China producing 24.4 million is leading among these countries. Now I want to look at the number of commercial vehicles produced by these countries as well. So again, I'm going to type in is equal to VLOOKUP, select the cell, comma. This time, I'm going to select the table in a slightly different way. And this is my recommended way because it helps, it's faster, and it helps you in some ways. You do not have to freeze the range. What I'm doing here is I'm selecting this column header. So I'm starting with column B and dragging it all the way to the right. The other benefit of doing this is, as you can see at the top right, you can actually see the in this small white box, it shows you the number of columns. So you can see that it's 1048576R, which is indicating this is the number of rows that have been selected into 4C. So it's indicating you the number of column that you have selected. So in this case, if you want to see what is the number of column for commercial vehicles, because at this point I'm looking at looking to look up the commercial vehicles, it shows that it's 3C. So I know it's column 3. Now in this case, we have a small table with only 5 columns. We already know that it's column 3. But if we have a very large table with a lot of column numbers, this way you can quickly see what is the number of column that you are looking for, and this helps you once you have selected the range and then you put the column number. So in this case, it's 3. Now you press comma again, and then you will type false again, and you enter, and you can see still it gives you the results. Now again, you drag it down and you have your number of commercial vehicles produced by these countries. Interestingly, you can see that USA prepares or produces a lot more commercial vehicles than the passenger vehicles. Now, it is important to remember that for VLOOKUP to work, the data that you are looking for, which in this case is the name of the country, should be the first column in your selected range of data. So in this case, as you can see, column B is the first column of our selection. If it's not the first column, VLOOKUP function does not work. Another question that you may have is, what is the true or false, or what is the approximate match or exact match? Well, for this, you can see the link in the description below. I have another video which will explain exactly what is approximate match and exact match. If you like this video, click like and subscribe to my channel for more Microsoft Office, especially Microsoft Excel videos.